shoes.
Can Kim and Aggie junk all the gummed up gunk and make this mess minty fresh?
Oh, God, Aggie.
Oh. Aggie.
Or will they throw in the towel?
Why did we have to do that?
Kim Woodburn and Aggie McKenzie, Great Britain's supreme beings of clean, are sweeping across America to find our nation's filthiest homes and make the country shine.
Look at this here, Aggie. God, sit. You never stop, woman.
Be quiet, Aggie.
This week, they're in Marina Del Rey, California, home to Jane Lieberman, health food aficionado, fitness fanatic, and filth offender.
You can say that your body is a temple. That is true. But then I do not live in a temple. You know, it's almost like this evil twin.
She's an avid worker-outer, isn't she? She's got muscles in her water. Why doesn't she clean her condominium?
Oh, exactly. She could use a bit of exercise around there.
Kim and Aggie summon all their strength to search this sordid scene.
Well, it looks very nice to me.
Lovely.
Well, come on.
Seems a bit odd.
Be optimistic.
Isn't it?
Oh my goodness me! It looks like it's been burgled, doesn't it? What's this, Kim?
That is a sports bra. It wouldn't fit me, mind you. It wouldn't fit one, dinner, mind two.
No.
But you could put it around your ankle.
Yes.
That is so pretty, Ag.
Oh!
Watch yourself.
Get the boot!
Oh, for the love of God, What's
down
on my flaming shoe?
Sorry, I think it's hilarious.
It's not funny, that's revolting.
Oh, look, more gum there, look. She's a gum queen.
I've chewed gum, sugar-free, of course. It's too much trouble to go throw it away. So wherever I am, pretty much it stays.
Looks like Aggie finally owns a pair of Jimmy Choos.
Well, I'm going to investigate all this. Oh, my God.
Oh, God, that's not nice.
Oh,
Aggie, what's this?
What? Oh, you've just slapped off.
So
thank you very much.
So
oh, thank you so much.
I was just trying to, look.
All over my legs and stockings.
Darling, I'm so sorry.
Oh, Aggie, you're so... Look, I have a... Give us a...
Oh, look at this.
I'm so sorry.
You did that deliberately.
I promise I didn't. Look, we've made the sofa really dirty now.
Never mind the sofa. What about my hose and whoop?
And skirt.
Get out of my way.
If your husband could see you now.
I might turn him on and bent over and pinch the skirt.
Kim, it gets a lot worse up here.
Do you know, Aggie, I paid $30 for these knickers. I've got $15 worth up me bum. Crawling all over this flameless.
Oh, no.
Hang on, I've got to adjust myself. Most uncomfortable, Aggie, when you've got knicker crawlers.
Oh.
I'm frightened to walk. Oh, something wet on my foot.
Oh,
look at my foot. I'm look. There's pools of water. Look, it's dripping.
There's even more moist muck in Jane's jarring kitchen.
Oh, my goodness.
That's disgusting.
How many bottles are in here? There's not a square inch of countertop. Okay, look.
Organic.
More flaming gum on the side of the bottle.
We have to think of a new career, dear, because this is killing me.
Who's in this countertop, Kim? Oh. It's never had a wipe.
Look at the state of it.
Oh,
slimy.
What does
nasty.
It smell like, Aggie? Go on. What is that?
It's oil, grot nastiness with a bit of hair thrown in.
Oh, Kim, you know what? There's chewing gum on the floor.
Oh, what a surprise.
That's just attracting all these coffee grounds.
Is that chewing gum?
Yes.
Kim, have you seen this little delight?
Oh, yuck.
Oh, God, Aggie.
Oh, why did we have to do that?
That tainted towel is a treat compared to what's fermenting in the fridge.
Oh, get over here. What is that?
Aggie,
there's no
what's that?
Entry.
What's that?
It's a squash. It's a very squashed squash. Oh, lovely. Have a sniff. Go on, have a good old sniff.
Oh, my God.
Yes?
Last time I saw one that length, I was much younger.
Were you now?
By Jove.
Didn't know you liked carrots. I thought you were into vegetables.
Oh, yeah, animal vegetable and mineral, dear.
Oh.
You know nothing about me, Aggie. I have a secret life you know nothing about.
Well...
It does not involve carrots, I can assure you.
Do you know, I smell like a polecat, you know?
Is my fragrance gone?
Well gone.
Well shot to pieces.
Well, it was evening in Paris. It's now night in a dustbin.
There's no lids on anything.
I can take off a lid of a yogurt, and then where is it? I didn't even realize I did it. It's like I space out, you know what I mean, flip my lid.
I know, what the heck is this?
Fancy little picnic.
I'm not taking that home for lunch, I can assure you.
Yes, never in my life.
This grime suspect should be arrested for appliance abuse.
The smell.
It looks like that toilet we saw the other week, doesn't it?
I'm gonna be sick.
That is really bad. It's
Hexy.
So... She's left her trail. More chewing gum.
She likes newspapers because she never... Look at the whole floor.
She likes them so much, she can't bear to throw them away.
Yeah, watch. Just goes on and on and on and on.
And on. This exercise fiend has a bathroom filthier than a field house floor.
Ooh! What's that in there?
It smells.
Is that hair?
Poor. Stinky boots. Oh, yeah, lots of hair. Let's have a look. Looky, look, looky, look.
Oh, God, what is... Oh, that's disgusting.
And yet not difficult to clean.
What is that? Did she make coffee down here or what?
Well, nasty.
That's feces, isn't it?
Dried on urine.
And look at this here, that's pee-pees.
See, that's disgusting, isn't it?
Yes.
And yet, Aggie, you know, as you said, no smell. No. She must toss coffee cups down, you know? And over there, but if she doesn't she pull the chain to disperse them?
I know, it's very odd.
I just don't understand this. I'm not with this at all.
No,
that
me
is
neither.
That is not feces, thank
me
God.
Me neither.
Oh, God, not again. And it's got feathers on this time. Do you know what? I'm going to take these flaming shoes off and go barefoot.
Time to burst Jane's bubble.
Could you get that gum out of your mouth, please? There's enough inside.
Sorry.
Take it with you. I don't want any more of it.
Can Jane cope with the cleaning calisthenics that Kim and Aggie have in store? And when Aggie shines her light, is Jane in jeopardy from germs?
I can see all the bacteria hanging around here.
Aggie and Kim, England's emissaries of home economics, have come to clean the cruddy condominium of gum junkie Jane Lieberman.
Gum on my flaming shoe!
Somebody's gonna get chewed out.
You live in filth. You have a luxury place
that
people would die for.
I know.
You've got chewing gum. You're not 5 years of age anymore. Why don't you throw it in a bin? Because you can't be bothered, can you?
Yeah, that's I hate you. To say it.
I'm
lazy,
glad
lazy.
You have the grace to blush.
Yeah.
And what about that fridge, Jane? For the
love that's because
God,
of the
that
lid.
Fridge.
The lids.
Forget the lids. Have you seen the gunk?
Well,
the
that's what I mean. The things will fall over. Like, I mean, it's happened on occasion. I've opened it up and something has fallen on my head or
and
my toe.
Oh, I thought something fell on your head. That cannot surprise me. I think lost has fallen on your head. The clutter's got to go. You've got to be ruthless.
I'm at your mercy.
Let's get weaving. Come on, Agsy.
This fitness fan needs to do some declutter curls. 10 reps and about 4,000 sets.
Shake a leg, dear.
All right, we're moving. I'll think of it as a cardio activity.
Yeah, whatever blows your skirt up, do you think of it? I don't care.
That's disgusting.
Is this the picnic you're planning later on?
No, I did buy the chicken, though, at a health food store, because I thought if I were ever sick, I'd want some chicken and, you know, already cooked.
Well, you think you recover eating that?
Time to get this unhealthy house in shape.
Kim's looking fierce, but for this event, she needs to sport her grime fighting gear.
I'm really getting into this California lifestyle. Staying fit, actually.
What about that house in there?
You tackle all the gum.
Yeah.
And also the kitchen.
So what are you going to do then?
I'm doing the bedroom.
Come on. Get moving.
Our dream cleaning team is ready for action. First up, Aggie tackles Jane's addiction.
Stains on your carpet, Jane, are one thing, but bubble gum is another.
I don't know how it got quite in that corner either.
Well, I think from the mouth to the hand to the floor, probably. Or else...
Or maybe it got on my shoe.
Yeah, and then you can talk to me about gum on shoes. Thank you very much.
Oh, you got some?
Some. Loads, actually. Oh. Here's an easy way to get rid of this.
Okay.
Bag full of ice cubes.
Right.
Stick it on the top. Leave it there a good few minutes.
Mm-hmm.
Hardens the gum.
Ooh.
Makes it really rigid. Then it should chip off quite easily.
While the gum gets firm, so do Jane's triceps.
60.
God, Jane, I think you should stop there.
All right,
you
62.
You don't want to use up all your energy.
Yeah, we got a lot more cleaning
for the
to do.
That's right. Okay, right. Let's see if this is cooked yet. Nice and solid. Oh, there we are.
Very it's nice.
One. Now, this has left a wee bit of colour behind.
Yeah.
I'm going to get some white turpentine and a white cloth and have a good go at this.
Wow.
It's come out onto the cloth.
Very nice.
Jane's disposed of the bubble gum. Now she conquers bathtub scum.
Jane, your bath is very, very dirty. Tide marks are terrible. And all I need to do is immerse this in water.
Mm-hmm.
Squeeze it out. Watch this here. I've got here.
Oh, my.
Isn't it? Look at that.
And easy, too.
And look how white already. Look.
Oh, wow. That's great. Okay, we'll get some muscle.
Look at the dirt coming off.
Wow, already.
Lord above me. So why don't you, instead of going every day to the gym,
mm-hmm.
why don't you get every other day, and the day you don't go, spend your time cleaning your house, you'd burn as much and get a clean home as well as a good figure.
What I was thinking is maybe I would go and then do this in addition.
Do whatever you like, as long as you clean the house, I'm a happy lady.
Well, I'm sure I will be too.
Good.
Jane's washing and wiping workout is well underway. Now, Dirt Detective Aggie finds out how fit her fixtures are.
Although surfaces in the home might look clean, it doesn't mean to say they are clean. I've got a special ultraviolet lamp here that will highlight bodily fluids present. My goodness me, I'm going to take some swabs here now that I can send back to the lab to find out exactly what bacteria are present and the dangers they pose.
Aggie's microbial mission doesn't end there. Now she stakes out the food supply.
You can see all the bacteria hanging around here. Now, I suspect that some of this may have come from the bathroom. And you can see it's all over the floor as well. I can't wait to get the results of this.
Could Jane's fridge be filthier than her toilet?
430 times the number of bacteria in here.
You've actually saved my life.
And can Jane handle the strain of the scum still to come? Feel the burn, Jane. Jane's body is buff, but her condo is in critical condition. So Aggie and Kim have been coaching her through some antiseptic aerobics.
I knew I was working out for a reason.
Now Kim gets her pumped up about a spotless shower stall.
You see all this on your windows?
Right.
The trouble is you shampoo your hair. It goes onto the window, so you're not just water, it's scum, it's dried up soap. The only way you can really remove that quickly is by using vinegar and water, good old-fashioned white vinegar. I'm going to rub it in with this kitchen paper, so I'm going to do that. Mm-hmm. Newspapers polish glass beautifully. I tell you something I've noticed in this house, you're never short of newspapers, are you?
No.
You know the way you're working like that?
Yeah. Is that
work?
Good?
Absolutely.
Oh. Good.
You work that way. And then when you go and clean the outside, you work that way.
Oh, the other side.
And
I mean,
that
the other
way you can see if there's any marks you've missed.
Excellent.
Right?
Yeah.
To make this putrid place a powerhouse, Kim and Aggie bring in a little extra muscle.
Don't let us down. Aggie,
on your mark,
Get set. Go!
And the decathlon of dusting and disinfecting continues. Maggie uses her filth-fighting physique to break down what's been building up in Jane's laundry room.
Let's put some liquid soap on the stains, and I've got the stain brush here that will work the liquid right into the fabric. Okay. Just get it activated before you put it into the washing machine.
There's many uses too, I'm sure.
And this is not Sex in the City, remember?
Jane's gym clothes will be gym dandy in a jiffy. Now the race is on to get this fusty flat smelling fresh. So Kim brings together a dream team of rose petals, lavender, cinnamon, and a little performance enhancing jasmine oil.
Anki, I folded them into four and I scrunched this. Take a handful.
Oh, that's a little more lavender.
Stay central. That's the joy of it. You can please yourself. Get your band round. Take a pretty piece of ribbon, to a nice bow, and there we have potpourri that we really love.
Every event in Jane's decathlon of domestic disinfecting has served as a warm-up to this appalling oven.
We've got a hell of a microwave in there. What a state it's in. I'm going to show you an easy way to get that clean. Put a couple of slices of fresh lemon in the bowl. Then stick the bowl into the microwave. Mm-hmm. Turn the microwave on between 1 and 5 minutes. So the steaming water will loosen off all the fat and the burnt on food.
Okay.
And also the lemon will help to deodorize it and make it smell really fresh and lovely.
Very nice. So how long do you have to wait for this?
Only a couple of minutes, but I tell you what, Miss Fitness, why don't you do some front lunges or whatever you call them with these things? And oh my goodness.
Ooh, all that landed in there.
Let's see how it's all
It's
really loosened it. Look at the state of these.
It's the final leg of our maintenance marathon. And Jane's been sent out for a spin. Will all the gunk be gone when Jane gets back?
Oh, my God!
And Kim and Aggie get a surprise of their own when they pop back in for a visit. Kim and Aggie and their team have been working up quite a sweat, sanitizing the chaotic condo of exercise enthusiast Jane Lieberman. Now they've come up for air. Really foul-smelling air. And Jane has jogged back to see what's happened to her home.
Come here, Jane. Look at all this trash in here that came out of your condo. You shocked?
It's embarrassing.
It's
embarrassing.
To me, dear little soul, this must not happen again. Are you listening to me?
I promise. Never.
You're not going to clutter up again,
no,
are you?
No, no. Less is more.
Come on, let's go and see.
Come on, young lady.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God!
Jane's living room was a labyrinth of litter, grunge, and gum. Now it's straight, sterile, and unstuck.
I've never seen this place look so... I've never seen it look so... I didn't think I would cry at all. Really, this is just so beautiful.
You have a beautiful home. That's what we said
you
to
really
you.
Do. Yeah. Really, really
you
worth
did it, darling. Come on.
Oh, come on, little one. Oh, you got me going now.
Eating healthy was an oxymoron in this sickening kitchen, till Kim and Aggie made the whole place wholesome.
Do you recognize it?
Hardly.
Now, if you look in this fridge here, okay, you can see it's lovely and clean. Do you recognize this thing on top of the container?
Yes.
Yes.
A brand new Tupperware.
Let me tell you, Jane, why it's so important to put your lids on. I took some swabs from the loo upstairs, okay? You had 1,300 units of bacteria of Staphylococcus aureus. I think you call it commonly staph in this country.
Okay.
It sounds to me as if
that's
the
scary.
Bacteria are going from there onto your hands, into the fridge. There were 430 times that many bacteria inside your fridge. Your toilet was cleaner
than the inside of your fridge where you're storing your food. And this will give you stomach infections, it will give you pus-forming infections, and in extreme cases, it could give you septicemia and you could die. It's as dangerous as that. I'm not joking.
You've actually saved my life.
There was nothing but bad news strewn in Jane's bedroom, but now it's making headlines.
Oh, it's gorgeous. I thought I was carpeted with newspapers for a while.
Washing in Jane's grubby tub was like soaking in a septic tank. Now she'll be soothed in a tranquil spa.
Oh, my God.
Jane's John was unspeakably unsightly. Now her Lou is a looker.
Come on, get on her knees.
Watch. She does this all the time?
Yeah.
Beautiful. Breathe the fresh air down that loo.
That's unbelievable.
To make sure Jane keeps her commitment to cleaning, Kim and Aki give her some chewable chores.
Oh, my God. A gumball machine.
Now, Jane, we don't expect you to give up your gum habit,
okay.
But there is...
Good. Let's be realistic here.
But there is a catch.
I've never seen this. What clean oven.
Every time you have a piece of gum, you got a chore to do. How's that for a deal?
That's great. Bye. Please come back, but
we
not
will.
For the reason.
Well, please come back to a tidy place. Come on, Axie.
Bye.
Bye, Jane. Smashing to meet you.
Thank you so much.
She's been good. She's thrown loads at me. I'm on a high, Axie.
Oh, good.
Come on.
Inspired by Jane's commitment to fitness, Kim and Aggie have started training in tandem. Here's a chance to check on Jane's cleaning regime.
Let's just pick
just put it gently there. Oh, my God. Oh, I'm dying to see this place, do you know?
Hello, Jane. Are you there?
Quiet. Have a look and see. Like,
have a wee look and see if she's in.
Let's have a look in here.
It's very dark in here. I don't think she's at home, actually.
What are you doing? Kim? Where'd you learn how to do that?
So don't call me Sherlock Holmes for nothing.
Oh,
Watson.
My God.
Kim!
Oh, my God, the alarm. Whose idea was
quick,
this?
Quick, have a look at the bike.
Do
quick,
I look stupid?
Kim!
Oh, forget the bike, forget the bike!
Oh,
come on.
On the next survival guide.
Facing your breast exam. Great idea.
Oh!
Uplifting information.
The best bra for you would be an underwire.
Real advice all wrapped up in a not-so-real world. The Smart Woman Survival Guide, tonight at 8 on W.